Hey folks, I'm Tab with TNC Lawn and Landscape. So this video will be showing you guys how you can build a leaf box on standard, normal utility trailer. But a lot of folks told me that you can't really do it. So I'll show you how you can and what I use to do it and why we went with the setup of like this size and not the full trailer. And I'll show you what leaf loader we got here.
Here we go. I'm in that dope again, I'm in that flow again. Switch up the flow again, yeah. Flat in the parachute, gripping that pole again. I'm on that all again, yeah. Candy in the cup, gotta get paid.
Hey there, so on this side, this is the driver's side. We have just these normal rakes. These are good for thick leaf piles to push them into the loader, but we have the 2x4s here, these are plywood walls. I got these in 16 length, cut them to size and everything. Got these plywood sheets, they're 4x8 sheets. The trailer is 7 feet tall by 8 feet long by 77 inches wide. It's just put into the frame here with some bolts, and then the rest of it's wood screws. Has a mesh tarp on the top to keep everything in, but it still gives us some breathing in there so it doesn't get too hot or build up heat or anything. So let's move to the leaf loader here and we'll show you that. Alrighty, so here this is our 18 horsepower Billy Goat. It says the 18 horsepower Vanguard. It's got this with the key start and the pull start. Yeah, this thing is very nice. It takes leaves like a champ. I put this hour meter on it whenever we picked it up back in July. We got it pretty early, but it has 17.7 hours now. I think we paid around five to five six-ish. And yeah, this mount here, I welded it myself. Just used some angle iron and some square tubing. Put it onto the trailer right here with another support back here on the back. The leaf loader just sits on it, and it has holes in the leaf loader that we put some more bolts through, and it's pretty solid and doesn't move. And yeah, here we're on the other side. This is the big inlet tube. This tube is a 10 or 12 inch, I think. That's the same thing as the other side with the plywood and everything. It's got some rakes here. These are great. Come back here. The hook back here that we hook the leaf loader handle onto. And then just use a bungee cable, that way it keeps it up out of the road whenever we're driving. Same with this ratchet strap here. I welded these D-rings on here, that weld is not good, but just hook this ratchet strap to that D-ring, and then it keeps this hose up and keeps it from dragging on the ground and everything. This is the mount thing for the chain that you can hook on here so it doesn't hang low, but we did take that off. Just haven't really put it back on. But that's there. If we did use it, but we just took it off whenever we had to fix the hose. Yeah, same thing. Plywood, mesh tarp. Yeah, let's move on back to the back. Alrighty, so back here is the spare space we left for the box. We did this on purpose so we can keep the push mower or the 36 inch John Deere, or we even sometimes put the big 54 on here. That fills up the whole space, but we kept it like this so we can bring like the mowers like we have here to finish over the yard or use it as a leaf plow. This is very nice to have the mowers with us whenever we need them. But we're gonna come up here. We have the X-Mark 21 inch commercial right here. We use this for the smaller places that we want to bag up. Then on the other side, we have the John Deere, I think that's a Quick Track 636M, 36 inch stand on. That thing's very nice. We just picked that up a little while ago. It's about 30 hours on it and everything. But yeah, we just left this back here so we can put the mowers, or if we need to put sticks or something back here, we have that room along with the leaf box. So we're going to open this up here. You can see these shred pretty well. You want to come in here to see it better. It's not all the way full, but it's shredded pretty well. These are very compact and stuff. So We're gonna hook chain up. Chain is down here. We just kind of keep it to where we can pull it. Like right here. And then, yeah, we pull this all the way out. And then we connect it back to over here. And then we back up. And pull straight out. And then this just comes out the big old cube. So we'll get this hooked up and then pull it out. So here's what the box looks like on the inside with the door open. So like I said, this door swings out and this one swings up. And yeah, this is pretty much what it looks like. That big old square in there, that's for to protect the battery, because whenever I was building it, the battery stuck out to there, so I'm just kind of put the battery box kind of cover over it and whatnot. That's obviously the inlet, or the outlet, sorry, of the leaf loader, and then you can see the mesh tarp or whatever you want to call that. Just got some simple supports that go across there. One more back here at the back. But yeah, this thing's sturdy. It's not going anywhere. But yeah, that's the inside of the box. But so here it is. Here's the pile. Like I said, we were not full at all. Yeah, but these are compact a lot. Like, they're shredded up very nicely. We can fit a lot of leaves in this box, but everything's put back together now. Yeah, we got the mower back here and ready to go. So yeah. All right, so you guys just saw that's the full leaf box and everything. Why we keep everything the way it is, but the truck we pull along with is a Chevy 2500. It's a 2003. That's a 6.0 gas. This thing's very nice. It pulls this trailer and the mowing trailer. We even had a dump trailer hooked up to this with about 10,000 pounds of dirt. It pulls it like nothing. Yeah, it does suck on gas, but that's about it. I like this truck a lot. It's very nice. Pulls everything perfect. And yeah, so if you guys enjoyed the video, hit me a like or whatever, and then subscribe. But yeah, that was the end of the video. And yeah, this is the leaf box set up and what we did this year. Might change next year or put up a dump trailer, but we'll just see. So yeah, thank you guys for watching. I'll see you in the next one.